Well, winter has finally came upon us. So for being honest, not as chilly nor snowy as the winters in Chicago that we're used to, but I'm not complaining. Keep it like this. I'd rather take 30-degree weather and not snowing versus 20-degree weather and icy and snowy all the time. I hate cleaning off my car, so I'm fine with this weather, to be honest. I'm not here to talk about the weather. I'm here to talk about what I'm going to be reading this winter. So I plan on either finishing reading, starting reading, or completely reading 5 books this year, this season. And that doesn't seem like a lot, but most of these books are pretty large, so, me a little bit, if being honest. So let's get this started. I just started reading The Hero of Ages, which is book 3 in the original Mistborn trilogy by Brandon Sanderson. I really enjoyed the first two, and I am enjoying this one so far. Though I don't know, don't have much to say about it, as I'm only maybe 7 chapters into it. If you're fans of epic fantasy, you definitely enjoy this. If you're fans of like the political intrigue of Game of Thrones books, you probably enjoy this too. A lot less brutal than Game of Thrones. So, if you're in like middle school, it'd probably be appropriate for you to read these. Not to say they aren't intense, they are pretty intense books, but nothing gratuitous. So, this is a fantasy series about people who can bend metals to do magic. It's based on metals. So you could like fly, or it could give you strength, or it could, change your age. But one of the main things it could do is influence people's emotions. So you could do stuff to make them angry, do stuff to make them, calm and serene. The Serene from Atlantis, the emotion Serene. And it's basically, the first book is about trying to tear down this evil empire, and then the other two books are like, now what? When you defeat the evil empire, now what do you do? It's not going to be perfect, So very interesting. I feel like a lot of fantasy series don't really touch on that. In Lord of the Rings, when you defeat Sauron, it's like, everything's great, yay! About how like the government would change and stuff. So, very good, very intense. I love the characters, especially Vin and Sazed are probably my favorites. Though I also like Elend, and Kelsiel. But yeah, if you like fantasy, political intrigue, I recommend it, and I cannot wait to finish it and talk to you guys about it. Like I said, I'm still at the beginning of it, so I don't expect a review until the end of January. I said this last TBR, and I never got around to reading it, but hopefully I'll finally be able to read Big Little Lies, the book that inspired the HBO TV show, of which me and my family are a big fan of. And it's good timing too, because Nicole Kidman just announced that they're going to make a season 3. So, I'll read the original book to refresh myself on some things, because whenever I see a movie or a show I like, my instant thought is, oh, I wonder if the book's good. So probably be reading this in late January and early February. Probably only take me maybe 2 or 3 weeks, because it doesn't look that long. So I'll let you guys know what I think about it in early February. After that, I'll be reading Worldbreaker by Brandon Sanderson. I'm really, to be honest, don't know what this book is about at all. Except that it involves color magic, magic influenced by colors, while with Mistborn it's magic influenced by metals. I really avoid looking at what the book's about. If it's by an author I already like anyway, odds are I'm gonna read it. So I really like going into books clean, not knowing anything. I usually enjoy things better when I don't know much about them. So that'll be the same with Worldbreaker. It would be nice though, because like I said, Mistborn is a 3-part series, while Worldbreaker is a standalone, at least for now. So I could just enjoy it as a standalone book. I haven't read a standalone book in a while. That's also why I'm excited to read Big Little Lies. It's a nice little palate cleanser in between these big series. Speaking of big series, I'm gonna start Harry Potter again. I read these back in middle school. Haven't read them since, though I have seen the movies a few times since. This has been on my list for a while, but the main reason I'm pushing it up is because I went to Universal Studios back in November with my grandma and my sister, and we saw Harry Potter Land, and being there really wanted me to, really made me want to read the Harry Potter books again. So, in Malt, so I'm going to be reading the Soul Soul Stone, also known as the Philosopher's Stone, if you're a Brit. So now I'm a big J.K. Rowling fan, based on how much I like her strike books and these books, so it's nice to dump back into the Wizarding World while I wait for the eighth strike book, whenever that may be. And finally, I'm going to start this, but I probably will not be able to finish this in Malt, is the Ray of Kings by Brandon Sanderson. So I really don't know what this is about. Like I said, I don't even read the back cover of the book because I like going into things blind. But if it's as good as Elantris and Mistborn, then I probably like it. The cover, if you could see, is one of the most beautiful covers I have ever seen in my life. The vivid, I'm not really a stickler for colors, but just the beautiful sunset and the souls of guy looking out into it and the clouds, everything about it looks so epic and beautiful. Like, if they made a movie version of this or a TV show version, this shot better be in there because it looks incredible. So, shout out to the cover artist. They say I don't judge a book by its cover, but you know, if the book's nearly as cool as this cover is, I'll probably like it. Like I said, have no idea what it's about because, like, Worldbreaker, I already like this author anyway, so odds are I'm gonna like the book. Like, reading into what a book's about if I'm just gonna read it anyway. And, like I said, this book's over 1,000 pages, so I probably won't even finish this until May. So, it's kind of end of winter, early spring, so I just include it on both TBR. So get ready for me to talk about it next TBR. Oh my. Up next is the TV and movie section of this video. So, because of the strike, there hasn't been that many shows being announced to air in the wintertime. Some of them are still up in the air, like the I don't know when The Boys is coming back. I don't really know when House of the Dragon's coming back. Invincible's coming back. The only thing we've gotten a confirmation for actually coming back is True Detective, which I'm gonna be cautiously optimistic because, I liked 1 and 3 of True Detective. Well, I didn't like 2, but the new one, Night Country, is not by the same writer, though he will be executive producing it. Still, leaves me a little bit worried that it won't live up to the expectations. I do like Jodie Foster as an actress, and I heard Christopher Eccleston was in it. Being a Doctor Who fan, obviously I'm excited for that. So we'll wait and see. As for movies, I already have tickets to see two movies come that came out last week, I think. The Holdovers, which stars Paul Giamatti, and it's about him playing a teacher who has to watch over kids who stay home, stay at the college during winter break. I heard it was a good movie. My friend did not like it, but everybody's different. I like judging things for myself. So expect a review on that on the 7th. And on that same day, I'll be seeing Godzilla Minus One in theaters with my friend. I don't really know what it's about, despite the fact that it has Godzilla in it. But the fact that this movie has gotten so much hype being a Godzilla movie makes me want to see it. I've not seen a big franchise movie like this get so much hype since, like, I don't know, Top Gun Maverick in terms of quality. So, I'm gonna check it out. Hopefully it's good. I do like foreign films once in a while, so, it's a nice change of pace from American films. You guys know what I think of that on the 14th. The only other new movie I plan on seeing is Dune 2, which finally will be out in March unless they delay it again, but they better not. I'm telling you guys, they better not. In terms of old shows, I have been watching season 6 of House with my mom, the Jeremy Brett adaptation of Sherlock Holmes with my dad, getting up to Jujutsu Kaisen. Me and my dad have been watching South Park. We're on season 4 right now. Very hilarious, and I like how it's a little bit more serialized. We'll be finishing up the final season of Fargo, well, season 5 of Fargo, the final episodes. And I've been going through the William Hartnell episodes of Doctor Who, whether it be through Tubi or the DVDs I already own or the DVDs from the library. But, I've been enjoying the William Hartnell era so much lately. I've been posting videos about them every Thursday if you want to check those out. I have been watching One Piece. I finished the Enies Lobby arc, and I think next week I'm going to be starting the Thriller Bark arc. Bark arc, that's hard to say. So, hopefully I like that. I kind of refrain from doing anime videos on this channel because I feel like whenever I do one, that's like, it gets way more views than the other videos, and it kind of takes away from the main focus on this channel, which is reading and, live action TV. So yeah, been kind of a long video, but this is everything I plan on reading, watching, during the months of January, February, and March. Please let me know what you guys are doing down in the comments below, what you think about any of those books I mentioned, any of the shows and movies I mentioned. I love having conversations in the comments section, so please leave me your thoughts. And thank you guys so much for watching. Have a happy new year. Until next time, peace.